Hey guys, Becky here with Design Bundles, and I'm super excited to have you join me today because we have a really exciting experiment slash project for you. We are making our very first water-resistant shirt. And if you don't know what that is, you don't want to miss this.
All right, guys, so here we are in Silhouette Studio. And first, you know, let me hit the pause button real quick because I always take it very seriously where we get the inspiration for projects. And this one in particular, this project, I read about in a Facebook group, okay? And I wish to my little heart's content that I could go back and find the post where I read this, but I guess I did not save it like I thought I did. So if you happen to be watching the video and you said, hey, I remember talking to you about this process, then please, please, please comment because I don't want anybody to think that I am, that I'm stealing designs or not designs, but tutorials, you know. It's definitely such a great community and you guys are always willing to share. And I love being able to take these ideas, turn them into, you know, visual tutorials that you guys can turn around and share with others. So let's keep the community going. But I just wanted to let you guys know that that was a thing because I just always believe in full transparency. So, but back to the project, we are here in Silhouette Studio. And the first thing that we're going to do is I always start with my page setup menu. All right. Now, one product that we're going to be using today is a letter size sheet of JetPro SS, which is a printable for light colors. It's a printable heat transfer paper for light colors. And what that means is that it is a basically clear transparent film that you are able to print on, and we have videos on using it in the printable fashion, but the film itself is transparent, so we're using it today to make a water resist shirt. And if you don't know what that is, I promise it'll make more sense once you get to see the actual project. But for our purposes on the page setup panel, we want to select the media size and change it to a letter size. Now, let's go ahead and bring in our SVG file. So you can go to File and Open, and I'm going to go to Downloads. And I'm going to open the SVG format. All right, now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and group this all together. I don't want to accidentally grab part of the design that I did not intend to grab and move it or mess up the design or the layout, okay? Now, the next thing I want to say is I'm putting this on an adult large t-shirt. So my adult large t-shirts, I prefer to do 11 inches wide. Let's switch our orientation to portrait. And you can see that by no stretch of the imagination is this going to fit on a letter size sheet. So the way that we're going to make this work is we are going to ungroup it and group it back together in two separate groups, two separate pieces. Okay, but we had it grouped together. That way we could size it together. Does that make sense? Okay, now we can take each individual piece and line it up just, you know, right there in the center of our page size here. And as long as we line up our material to look just like this on the page, then it'll cut just fine. Does that make sense? All right. Now, you know, normally for, you know, any type of heat transfer paper, for the light colors, you're talking about like you're going to mirror your design and this and that, but temporarily erase that from your memory because we're not using this in a traditional way. So we're not going to use it. We're not going to do the mirroring because when I lay the material on my cutting mat, I'm going to lay it backing side up. Okay. So the side I would usually print on is going to go face down. And that's because I'm going to use a patterns mask, a magic mask. It's a heat transfer masking. All right. It's heat safe. And I'm going to use that to pull my design from the grid, from the mat. Okay, I promise this will make more sense, but moral of the story, we are not going to mirror this design. Now, let's click over to our send panel. And for my cut settings, because I'm cutting all the way through this, I am going to choose cardstock plain. Okay, this setting works really, really well. And I can just zoom out. So now I'm going to send this. And it's important to know that once I'm done with this, don't go crazy moving off the mat. I'm actually going to use two separate cutting mats because I need my designs to stay intact. All right. So I'm going to cut this and then I'm going to actually load a new mat and then cut this part of the design. So when we reconvene over in the workspace, just know that I'm going to have two separate cutting mats. Okay, it's necessary for this project. Now, let's also pause and say, you don't have to do this large of a design, all right? You can start small. And I'll probably harp on that again later on in the tutorial, but you know, I'm doing this because, you know, I just am really self-conscious about my designs being too small on my shirt. I know that's a weird thing to say, but I am. So I just am splitting it up and I'm gonna show you how to combine them. And that's just an extra tip. So think of it like a twofer in this tutorial. I'm showing you how to split this up when you have smaller media size. And then I'm also showing you how to do the water resist shirt. And we're just knocking it all out at once. But guys, if you're ever in doubt, make sure you do your test cuts, all right? Better safe than sorry every single time. But this setting should work for you, all right? Now I'm going to send both of these. And like I said, we're going to reconvene in the workspace and I'm going to show you how to combine these and then also how to use this material in the, to use a water resist shirt. Okay. All right.
All right, guys. So let's take a look at what we have here. You'll notice I have two cutting mats and on each mat, just like we talked about in the software, I've cut part of the design just because I didn't want to be limited to the material size that we're working with. Now, just to show you, this is the JetPro SS, all right? This is a heat transfer paper for light colors. And what that means is that on the opposite side of this backing, you have just a regular, it looks white, but guys, it's actually transparent, okay? What that means is normally you would print on the front side and then press onto a light colored shirt to make a heat transfer, okay, an iron-on heat transfer. What we're going to do instead is we're going to rely on that transparency to use with our gray shirt, which is right here. Now, I chose gray because it works really well. It turns dark whenever you wet it, and that's going to work really good. And then what I have here, this is the same type of masking that you use for pattern heat transfer vinyl, also very similar to what you use for easy subly. Okay, so the first thing I'm gonna do, now the reason that I cut this on two mats is because I need this to stay in place. All right, so I'm gonna very carefully weed out the part that I don't need, including the inside pieces of the letters. Now I did make sure to choose two mats that are not very sticky, okay? This is not gonna work as well if you have super sticky mats. So just try to keep that in mind. So if you have any old mats laying around, use those. And also try to choose clean mats because the film that we're using is actually touching the adhesive right now. So you just want to try to keep that intact as much as possible. Okay, so this is the top part of our design. This is the bottom. So let's set this out of the way for just a minute and go ahead and grab our masking. Now I'm just going to remove the paper backing. What I'm going to do is try to center this as close as I can and smooth it down into place. Now this is not transfer tape, okay? This is a heat safe transfer material. Now I'm gonna turn it over and I'm gonna peel my mat back, okay? This works anytime you have problems getting your transfer tape or your heat safe transfer like this to stick to the surface. It also works really good for cardstock. If your cardstock is curling up, you can actually just roll the mat away instead. Now let's line up this part of our design. We'll do the same thing. Now, guys, if you're not overly familiar with using different materials with your machine, you may just want to stick to a design that is going to be one page. There's nothing wrong with that. I'm not trying to pressure you guys into thinking that you have to do a full design like this. Okay, so don't be afraid to start off with something a little smaller. I just wanted to show you guys that it is possible to use two sheets. All right, now our full design. There we go. So also, before I forget, and you know, I covered this already in the software, but I did make sure, like I talked about, I put the back side up because that is the part that you're going to apply the heat to. And this side is the actual side with the material, okay? So it was just like this on the cutting mat, which is also why we did not have to mirror our design for cutting out, okay? So let's go ahead and we'll throw a mat down. We will pre-press our shirt. Now I am at 375 for 30 seconds, okay? I don't have to press for 30 seconds on my pre-press, okay? And that pre-press also gives me a line right down the middle here. All right, smooth it out. Now I'm going to take my design and line it up as centered as possible. Once it looks good, we're gonna go ahead and cover it with our Teflon, and we're going to apply the heat. Now, my information sheet here, and this came with the page when I bought it, it says the 375 for 30 seconds, and it also says medium to heavy pressure. So that should be pretty close to what you're using for heat transfer vinyl. Also, my easy press is not as large as the design is, so I'm gonna be pressing in several areas, okay? Now this says that it can be peeled a hot peel, warm peel, or cold peel, and it can also be done with a home iron, okay? So you don't have to have a heat press to do this, but if you have a regular heat press, then you would only have to press this one time, or if you are working with a smaller design, okay? I'm only pressing so many times, that way I can cover each area with my smaller size easy press. So I should be able to go ahead and remove our transfer sheet, and then I should be able to very carefully remove the backing. Here, let's start in a cooler spot. Let's try some tweezers. Let's see if that'll help. Okay, so once you get it started, especially on an area with where it's cursive text, it should come off pretty easy. Now don't get discouraged. Of course, up close, you will be able to see the adhesive a little bit. That's okay, or rather the film, but just work with it slowly. Once you get the hang of what it feels like to peel it, it becomes a lot easier. All right, guys, so you can see. Now, this will look more natural after I wash it, okay? Because what you're seeing here and a little bit down here is a little bit of paper residue. That is A-okay. You will probably always be able to see the shine of it, okay? Because there is a film on there. But for the most part, especially unless you're up close and looking at it, like up close and personal, then you won't have to worry about that too much. But let me show you the big reveal. Are you ready? Now this is just regular water. And the more I spray it, the more my design becomes apparent. So this is where your sweat is going to come into play. And you know, it won't be quite as bright as this. Remember, like I said, that is actually a little bit of paper residue. But guys, I mean, you can easily see how when this is drenched, you're really gonna be able to make out your entire design. So that is what we have for your project today. Okay guys, so how did you feel about our water resist shirt? Now, I keep saying water resist, but let's be real. In a workout shirt like this, what we're resisting, the final outcome we're hoping for is a sweat resistant shirt, right? So when you get all sweaty, which is not something I really appreciate, but hey, you know, if you do and you want this style of shirt, this is a really easy way to get it done and pretty cost effective too, because even with two sheets of the JetPro SS, it really is not that expensive. It's not any more expensive than using heat transfer vinyl. So guys, if you have any questions or comments, definitely make sure you leave those down below. You guys know I love to hear from you. I always come back in and check in with you guys and help you any way that I can. And of course, make sure you subscribe to the channel and give it a big thumbs up if you learned something new. Maybe share with a crafty friend. I just really appreciate all the love that you guys show for us and for the channel, and I love bringing you these videos. So I'm gonna wrap it up for today, but thanks again for stopping by, and we'll see you again next time.